Welcome to this commentary. I'm Daryl Lanio and this is from DreamHack Summer Tournament 2011. We are watching Soccer against Rett, their first game in the 16 playoff. So we are closing in on the final. Okay, this is Crossfire and we see Soccer spawning as the blue Protoss in the upper right corner. We have Rett spawning as the red Zerg in the lower left corner. And I hope this will be a very interesting game. As I said, this is the 16 players moving from the group play up into the playoffs. And we can see one little probe here scouting from Sokka, moving down the map towards the base of Rett. Both players are expanding their economies, as you can see. Three drones morphing for Rett, while Soki is warping in one probe at a time. Another Overlord moving out to scout there. And nothing really special has happened yet. Rett is in the lead with 14 drones to 13 probes. But there goes one drone and morph into a spawning pool. And now they are equal, or about equal. Rett is at 15. Soki is at 15. We see a gateway and an assimilator coming in for Soki, while Rett is morphing in his spawning pool. As you might notice, we have a bit better frames per second in this first out of many commentaries, and this is because I upgraded my computer, so I have a faster drive and I have a faster computer to do these commentaries with, and you will get somewhat better frames per second because of this. I hope you enjoyed it. Okay, an extractor coming in for Rett, and we see that the pylon was cancelled by Sokka. He was able to make Rett a bit late on that second hatchery, but Rett is still expanding to his natural, while Soki has not expanded yet. Okay, we have followed that probe enough. Now let's look at the base of Soki. He is placing a gateway and a cybernetic core at his entrance, and he will probably get that Zealot that is almost finished. There it is. Yes, in this choke point, which will make him able to hold off attacks from, for example, Zerglings. Oh, that probe just barely got away with that scouting. We can see that this main base is saturated, just like the Zerg one. And this expansion is still not created yet, while the Zerg is almost done with his hatchery. An Overlord scouting back here at the gold. Another Overlord trying to get away from this Stalker. And these four Zerglings just keeping the map control here at the entrance on. The Protoss player is now forced to leave. So what will happen in this game? We see Warpgate technology being researched, maybe Foregate? No, we see Stargate coming in as well. That's early. So he went Gateway, Cybernetics Core, Stargate, and that will give him Void Rays and Phoenixes. Is there any air defense coming up for the Zerg? I don't think so, not yet. And there's the Void Ray, almost finished. So Soki is rushing to Void Ray, while Rett is going for a macro game, I would say. Still just having some Zerglings. He is researching metabolic boosts, so they will now become Speedlings. We see a second Void Ray coming in. The first Void Ray moving down here. Rett is at present supply blocked because one Overlord got killed. second gateway. And here comes the natural expansion for Sokka. It's been missing for quite some time, I would say. Burrowing being researched. As well as the Hydralisk Den morphing in, it will soon be completed, and that will probably save Rhett from a lot of trouble when this Void Ray comes in. We see a second Void Ray coming in here, and when those two attacks, it will not be easy to defend with just one queen. Is there a second queen moving down here? No, I don't think so. Yeah. He is moving down that queen. So this queen needs to back off summon. Oh, one phoenix as well, lifting up that queen. That queen will bite the dust. No, it didn't. It was saved by one other queen and a Hydralisk. So that harassment sort of failed for Sokka, and Rhett is slowly building up his Hydralisk army now. Is there any Roach Warren coming? No, so far no. So it will be Zerglings and Hydralisks. Unusual combination. We see those Void Rays move back again. Another Overlord there, and the Speedlings just checking out this base. What's morphing in here? Cannons, yes. Another attack by those pesky Void Rays. More Zerglings and a lot of Hydralisks. Yes, 11 of them moving up to this point, to the high ground, and we can see that. Was it both of them? I think so. Both Void Rays were shut down, but the Hydralisks are kept out while the Zerglings were killed. It was really both of them. It looks like that. I can't see any. I see a Phoenix here, but I don't see any Void Rays anymore. And yes, they were killed. So that was bad for Sokka and good for Rhett. Even though Rhett is at present supply block, he's able to attack. He is doing a walk around and being now able to attack from two sides as soon as that force field is released. He will be able to move in and kill off these cannons, and this doesn't look good for Sokka. How will he be able to defend this? I can see that he's researching thermal lands, and he has a Colossus on the field. He is producing yet another. Will those Colossus be able to take on this large army of Hydralisk? I don't think so. This Colossus needs to pull back slowly, and only two Stalkers here getting killed now. This looks real bad. Real bad. This Colossus is down to 41 hit points. Sokka is trying to save his probes, and those Hydralisks are now moving into his main base. Two Zealots coming out, and since he now has two Colossi, it will be possible for him, I think, to defend against this Zerg aggression. Even more Hydralisks and Zerglings coming in here, but two Colossus and a lot of probes, but he's not attacking with those. Might be able to hold this off. Does look a bit grim. The Zerg has map control in the Protoss natural base. One of the Colossi going down there. Just one Hydralisk left here now, and the remaining Hydralisks that were reinforcing are now backing off. So Sokka is able to repel that attack at a very high cost. This doesn't look good. As we can see, the Zerg has been able to move his creep up here. possibly through the use of a queen. And even though this phoenix is still moving around picking off overlords, Rhett is in a commanding lead with 140 max supply. He is up at 87 compared to Sokka's 68 and is maxed out. If we look at the units tab, we see that Rhett is in a slight lead in drones, so his economy is a bit better as well. Not that many probes got killed in that attack. That's good for Sokka. He was able to save his probes. Rhett is expanding to third base down here in the corner, so I guess you could call that an ninja expansion. He is... I don't think he's spreading his creep right now, but he has been very good at spreading it. Roaches added to the mix now. Of course, roaches and Hydralisk are a good combination. And we see Sentry, Stalkers and two Colossi moving out from Sokka's base. With the help of an Observer killing off those two Creep Tumors. And we see him move on here, killing more Creep Tumors on his way. Pylon to be able to warp in more troops. Oh! We have Corruptors in the air, and those will be able to chase away these Colossi. One got destroyed there. And even though one force field is able to hold back the ground troops, they are not able to hold down the Corruptors. Let's see what's happened here. I need a larger screen. I can't zoom out more though. With this many Corruptors, those Colossi won't be a large problem. However, those force fields are terrible for the roaches getting caught behind. Sarg is able to replenish fast with three bases. He has no problem losing a couple of troops. The Protoss player, however, has a real problem with that. Being short on warp gates as well, I think. I won't check that now, but we have a large engagement here between those two. Two more force field imprisoning a roach or two. Okay, the Zerg player is moving around, and I will take the chance to see. Okay, he has four gates at least. On two bases, that's too few, I think. Depending on the number of robotic space, of course. He is producing one immortal, but that only says he has one robotic spay. Large engagement now. These Stalkers will not be able to last, I think. It looks real bad for them. As I haven't hidden the clock, my mistake. We can also see that there's only 1.5 minutes left of the game. Colossi, a couple of Hydralisks, and four Roaches keep on attacking on the two remaining Stalkers there, blinking up to save themselves. More Stalkers warping in, but it won't be enough, I think. And if this attack on the Forge will keep on, this Forge will fall a second time. Fell during the first attack towards this base, and now it looks like it's going to fall a second time. Okay, those Hydralisks letting it go for now, starting to attack those Stalkers instead. He wants, of course, to keep his Corruptors alive, just in case there is another Colossi. And there goes the Forge field, the Forge. Just like I said it would. And here goes the gateway, and Sokka is tired of this game. He says GG and leaves. Rhett is the winner. Rhett is in the lead with 1-0 as we move on to game 2. Stay tuned and thanks for watching. Bye!